Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel, or if you're new here, welcome. Today we have a Bullseyes Playground haul. Now, let me first start by telling you this was done in about 3 different trips, because I don't want you to look at everything and be like, you are the reason that I can't find what I'm looking for because you and people like you hoard it. So, I have a few items that I have a lot of, but I have to say they were purchased in separate trips. I just want you to know that. As happy as I would be to get everything that I wanted that was on my wish list, I still haven't found everything, but I'm hopeful. My stores are just now getting in the fall things, and we're past mid-September now. So I'm hopeful that I'm still going to be able to find at least one tiered tray. I know that there's about 3 of them out there that I've seen people hauling. I just want one. Just one. So I'm hopeful I'll find that. I want some of the little ceramic houses that were out last year when I passed up on them. I'm sure there's a couple other things that I'm missing, but that's not why we're here. You want to see what I got, so let me show you. Okay, so we'll get the non-Bullseye Playground things out of the way first. First thing I got was just a plain black t-shirt for myself. Nothing fancy. Just got it from the clearance rack. I needed just a plain black t-shirt to use for layering under a different shirt or something. And it was $4.48 on clearance. So I picked that up for myself. For my little guy, he's needing some new pajamas for next year. And this was a 2-piece set, Paw Patrol. So you've got the little shirt with all the little pups on it. And then there's some shorts. And then you've got the other shirt here, and then the pants on the back. So, 2 set of pajamas, and that was $11.88 on clearance. However, if I remember right, I believe there was a cartwheel that day, and so I got an additional discount for using that. So, $11.88 still for 2 pairs of pajamas is a pretty good deal. And then I did pick him up one more pair. Just a cotton PJ zip up, and they were $6.28. So again, I think I used Cartwheel and got an additional percentage off. Plus, I always use my Target Red Card and got 5% off my total purchase. So every little bit helps. So you gotta save where you can, right? Okay. Then what do I want to do next here? Okay. So just a couple packs of dishcloths. I just needed some new ones. The ones I had were just getting so dingy looking, and no matter what I did, they just looked icky. So I decided to throw them out, and I'm going to start over with all white so that I can just bleach them and hopefully have a better result with these. I've not used these before. These are just the Target brand, Made by Design. I'm just calling them Bar Mop dishcloths. There's 6 of them to a package. I got 2 packages of them. So yeah, like I said, nothing too fancy, just some basic dishcloths, but I'm hoping that these will bleach out really well and hold up good for me. So we'll see. Okay. On clearance also, I found these Dylan's Candy Bar chocolate bars. This one is a pretzel crunch, and it was on clearance for 88 cents. I don't know, kind of sounded good to me, so I thought that would be something I would pick up, little treat for my kids, or possibly for me. Really don't eat a lot of this stuff anymore since I've gone keto, but every once in a while you gotta just treat yourself. And then I picked up a second one, this one's Brownie Batter, dark chocolate bar, and that was 88 cents as well. So, I'll try those out and see if they're any good. Alright, so now we are down to everything from Bullseye's Playground. I'm so excited, you guys. Okay, so the first things I found were these little wooden shadow boxes. So this one is just the natural color on the side, and then it has white on the interior. And I got 2 just like that, the natural on the outside, the white on the interior. Whoops, there's a front, I guess. And then they have the little hanger on the back, little sawtooth hanger. And then the third one I got is all natural. or actually it's all natural on the sides and the inside, and then it just has the outline of the white here. So I picked these up with my littlest guy in mind. We'll probably be redoing his room, I would guess, you know, maybe a year or so. He just turned 2, but I'm imagining that we're gonna upgrade his room, get him some new decor, and so I was picturing these going up on his wall. So I just thought I would pick them up while I saw them, because you all know, if you see something at Bullseye's Playground and you want it, you need to pick it up when you see it, because it's just might not be there next time. So pick those up, just gonna put those away for now and bring those out when we're ready to redecorate his room. Okay, and then along those same lines, talking about my little guy, if you watched any of my previous hauls, I'm really big on learning toys and teaching him kind of some early preschool type things, and so I found these little felt books. This one is Shapes and Numbers, and so it's just a little felt book, and all the pages are felt. I just thought it would be cute, something different than what we've already got, so I picked that one up for him. And then similarly to that, there's the ABC alphabet book. And then these two are Sounds of the Barnyard. It's just got all the different little farm animals in there and the sounds they make. And then this one is Good Grub, a healthy eating story. So I thought that would be fun. Something kind of different. So I got those. I picked these up. These were also on clearance. I just got these for my daughter. I just thought they'd be fun for her. She's a sophomore in high school. She loves to have stickers and things like that. So these little stickers were on sale for 89 cents, and they're just little donuts. I just thought they were really cute. And they've got, probably not going to show very well on camera, but there's some glitter inside of them. They're kind of like, it's almost like a bubble sticker. Like, what am I saying? Not a bubble sticker. A puffy sticker. It's like a puffy sticker, and then it's got like glitter inside of them, so you can just kind of shake it around, and I just thought it would be something she'd like, so pick those up for her. Okay, now, all the little treats that I found for myself or for our house, for decor, so excited. Okay, this table in front of me is full, you guys, you should see it. Okay, don't know where to start, I'm just going to start grabbing. Okay, first I found this pillow, hand-picked farm fresh pumpkins. How adorable is that? I absolutely love it. I love it. And then the back is just a solid green. So if you had green in your decor, you could easily display it like this throughout the year and then flip it around for fall. And I easily thought that this was going to be $5. And, oh, actually it was $5. My mistake. I was going to say, I think it was only $3, but no, it was $5. So I didn't think that was horrible. It's a cute little print. It's not something I've seen anywhere else, or maybe it's out there and I just haven't seen it, whatever, you know what I mean. So I picked it up, I thought it would be really cute. So we got that to go in our fall decor. Next up, I found some little bags, little mesh bags of, this one is just, they're calling it vase filler, but this is just like pears, little colored orange, yellow pears. And then similar to that, I got this little bag of apples. I would have liked to have found more apples, but they just had one little bag there. And then I got this little one of acorns. I thought that would be cute, maybe on my tiered tray, or in a vase, or, you know, on a wreath. Lots of options for those. And those little bags were $3 each. I maybe could have found something similar to it at Dollar Tree, but my Dollar Tree, just like everyone else's, is kind of hit or miss, and I haven't found the acorns that I've seen other people hauling anywhere at any of my Dollar Trees. So I was at Target, I saw them, I liked them, I decided to just pick them up. Also found this adorable wooden recipe card. This one is for pumpkin pie. There was also one for apple pie and I believe pecan pie as well. It's got a little jute twine hanger, so if you wanted to hang it from something. And this was $1. I'm kind of thinking I might try and incorporate this into one of my three-tiered trays. But you know, this would be super cute as a gift. You could get a pie pan, this little recipe card, some of the ingredients to go along with it, maybe like a dish towel. That would be a super cute gift, or a housewarming for someone. So, really cute. This is not something I'd seen anyone else haul. I don't know if I just wasn't paying attention or maybe people just aren't hauling it, but I found this tray. It's just a little metal tray and it's got the little rope handles on each end. And I don't know, I just thought it was different than, you know, the typical wooden tray that everybody has, which I have a couple at least. But really, can you have too many trays? I don't think so. So I picked it up. I'm not quite sure what I'm going to do with it yet, but I will figure out something for sure. And this was $3. I thought that was a really good deal. All right. I found this really cute basket, a little bushel basket. It's got the little fake leather handles on the side, or the ends, and you know, just a typical like bushel basket, like I would imagine like apples or something in here. And in fact, I think that's what I'm going to do with the apples that I got in the little bags, is maybe put some filler at the bottom and then set the little apples in here and use it as part of a display. And this was $3. I didn't think that was a bad price. It seems like it's made really well and it should hold up year after year. So lots of different things you could do with it. But yeah, I'm going to use mine, put the apples in it, use it for my, as part of my fall decor, which by the way, I will be doing a fall home tour once I get everything up and decorated. It's kind of a slow process because I have a toddler who wants to help. So I have to do a lot of the decorating when he's either preoccupied with the other kids or he's playing or when he's down napping. So I will be doing that and I will be trying to get that up as close to the first day of fall as I can, but stay tuned for that. That is definitely coming. All right, back to the haul here. So the next things I found, I'll show you all together. I found some candles. And this one says, Hello Pumpkin. And it has a little Buffalo Chuck cardboard piece to it. And it says it's scented as pumpkin. It just says scented candle, I guess, actually, but I mean, it doesn't smell bad. It smells good. I can't tell you what it smells like. It just smells nice, I guess. I just thought the little ceramic container was really cute, and then it's got the little cardboard wrap around it. I just thought it was just a really simple look, but just very classic, classy looking. So that candle was $3. The next candle I got is just precious. I love it so much. It's so, so cute. It's a little glass container made to look like a coffee mug. And then the little lid, just like a coffee lid. And this one is Sweater Weather. They're calling it Sweater Weather. Just a white candle. Again, nicely scented or I wouldn't have bought it. And I think I'm going to display this over by my coffee station. I just thought it would be really cute sitting there. Pop that little lid back on. And then this one is a tin. It's Harvest Pumpkin Bread. I don't believe I found this one. No, I know I didn't. I did not find this one at the Bullseye's Playground, Target Dollar Spot, whatever you call it. This was actually in the regular candle area, but it just smelled so good. I could not resist it. And this is, they're calling it Harvest Pumpkin Bread. It's a soy wax blend candle. And just has the white wax inside. Yeah, smells really, really nice. And that was $4.99 was the regular price, but I know that they were having a sale or I wouldn't have picked it up for $4.99. So, and there may have been a cartwheel on that as well that I used that day. Okay. I did find one house, little ceramic house, and it was hidden way, way down on a bottom shelf and behind a whole bunch of other things. So I'm not sure if someone was trying to save it for themselves, but I found it. The only one that I could find. So it's just got the little windows and the door and then the three windows on each side. It does light up. I don't think you're going to be able to tell when I turn it on, but it does light up. So I thought maybe I would try and put this on my three-tier tray or one of my three-tier trays to decorate with. We'll see. I'll definitely use it in my decor somewhere. I'm just not exactly sure where, so like I said, stay tuned for that fall home tour and we will see where it ends up. And that was $3 too, if I didn't tell you that, by the way. And probably my favorite item from this haul, the truck. I love it. I love it. I love it so much. So I ended up going with the blue. I think my only other option was green. So I think there was green and then the navy blue at my store anyway. And there were two of the navy blue left, so of course I had to scoop it up. And this was $3, so just a little ceramic truck. And this will definitely be in my decor somewhere. I love it so much, so cute. All right, I picked up this little garland. It's definitely very sparse for a garland, in my opinion. I think what I'm probably going to do, though, is I did really like the way they looked. You know, I like the green, a little variation of like the yellow and gold, a little bit of orange in there. So I think I am just going to maybe cut it apart and just use the pieces individually. You know, I could use them for a lot of different things. So I feel like for $3, oh, actually this is $5. For $5, that's not too bad, because if I were to go and want to buy something similar to this at Dollar Tree, you know, you're maybe going to get 3, 4, 5 little sprigs for a buck anyway. So, and I feel like I got more than that on here. So I liked it, picked it up. Definitely something that's going to get used. I've been seeing these a lot. They're just little stamps. It's a 30 count. You've got the alphabet and then some other characters, the ampersand, the exclamation point, question mark, and the hashtag. And I thought those would be really useful in some DIYs, just to have on hand. And it was $3. So I thought it was very reasonable to get 30 stamps for $3. Couldn't pass it up, so I picked those up. All right, you guys, are you ready for pumpkin overload? Tons of pumpkins. Tons and tons and tons of pumpkins. And I just dropped one. Okay, so I found, and like I said, I did not get all these pumpkins at the same time. They were done in like 3 separate trips, because every time I went, it was already either very picked over or they were just maybe just getting the inventory out. So like I said, not done all at one time. Okay, so we got 2 of the orange felt pumpkins. Oh, and I just dropped one. Just the felt, the little brown stem. So 2 of those. I got 2 of these, and I just dropped one. A little bit more of like the pear shaped, and they're gold. And then I picked up 3 white ones with brown stems. Just thought those are really adorable. You know, it's just they're that felt. They were $1 each. I feel like they're made really well. I really liked the burlap ones that Dollar Tree had this year, and I was only able to find one that was in good shape. The other ones that I found were all fraying or coming apart. So I really liked the looks of those, and so this gives me the same sort of feeling. It gives you that texture with the fabric on them. But it also adds like just a different element to the decor. So I really like those. That's why I gravitated towards those. I could not pass up the black and white buffalo check, so I got two that are in the smaller buffalo check print, and then I got one in the larger print. And again, these ones were also a dollar. And then I picked up the black and white, and these are a different fabric. These are almost a little bit kind of a velvet. I don't think they even really explain them. No, suede. They're calling it suede. So kind of a suede pumpkin. Just a different feel to it. And like, you know, the white ones, what are they calling the white ones? They called them felt. So these were more felt. So these are almost like more fuzzy to them. And then these are just like a softer fabric. And then the last two I got were one gray felt pumpkin again. And then this one is, they're just calling it a fabric pumpkin, and it's kind of the more natural looking one. Kind of almost looks like a burlap, and just a kind of a natural color. So got those to add to my fall decor. And the last thing that I have here to show you is this little wooden box. And that was $3. So I thought for the little crate for $3, that was a decent price. It's made out of the MDF wood. It's made really sturdy. It's gonna hold up well. So I thought that would be really cute to add to my decor, put something in it to display. You know, this is something that could be used year-round because it's not orange or gold or any of those fall colors. So can something I can definitely use, not just in the fall, but for other seasons as well. All right, you guys, that does it for my huge, or at least I feel like it was huge, Bullseye's Playground Haul. I'm super excited that I was able to find a lot of these things. Like I said, I have a wish list of things that I've been hoping to find. And was able to finally find a few over the course of two or three trips probably. So let me know what your favorite item was of this haul, or what items you're on the hunt for. Go ahead and leave me a comment below. If you like this video and want to see more like it, please go ahead and subscribe, give this video a like, and I'll see you on the next one. Thanks everyone. Bye-bye.